What's up, guys? This is Benro Tips and Tricks. Overhead tabletop shots are all over social media, hashtag work mode, hashtag foodie, to demonstrate do-it-yourself cooking recipes, product demonstrations, and arts and crafts. This popular POV, or point of view camera angle, can be challenging depending on how you're planning to approach the shot. There are several ways to achieve this type of shot. You could use a monopod, C-stand, and boom pole holder. Another option is a jib. However, these setups, you might run into some difficulty when having to make camera adjustments, since you'll most likely have to get up on a ladder or apple boxes to adjust camera settings. That can be so time consuming. A simpler way to approach these types of shots would be to mount a mirror above the subject. It will allow you to shoot up at the mirror from the ground with your camera on a tripod. Pretty easy, right? Now, you're able to have more control over your shot. If you're planning on doing overhead shooting, this rig will definitely save you time and aggravation. To set up your mirror rig, you can use these Kupo double convy clamps and attach this to Schedule 40 aluminum tubing. It's important to get the right position. A 45 degree angle is usually ideal. And if you're superstitious when it comes to broken mirrors, all jokes aside, safety comes first, dude. Make sure everything's tight. It's best to use a zoom lens when shooting into your mirror. This allows you to capture a variety of shots, including small pans and tilts, without having to move your tripod once your shot is all set up. Also, keep in mind that you'll be shooting into a mirrored reflection of your image, so any product logos or text on screen will be reversed. A simple solution for this is to add a horizontal flip filter during post-production. Voila, you're a magician. All it takes to get unique shots like these is a little bit of creativity and a lot of thinking outside the apple box. That's it for this edition of Benro Tips and Tricks. Thank you for watching. We'll see you next time.